What's up today, fellas? We just got the biggest storm so far of the season. I've barely had a chance to use either one of these sleds. But I want to talk about some overheating issues. And this video doesn't just pertain to Arctic Cat in general, even though my sleds are all cats. This pertains to, like I say, any make, model, or whatever. If you're having overheating issues, I'm going to explain a few different things in this video. What I dealt with, what I tried, how I fixed the issues. So I'll start off by saying I've had this Crossfire now for, wow, probably 13 years or so. Since 2010 I had this sled. Drove it a few years and I built the motor, did a whole bunch of modifications, changed the gearbox, blah blah blah. Long story short though, shortly after buying this sled, it drove so much stuff off the track that it tore the factory flap off it, like within, I don't know, probably the first year I had it, honestly. And I never ever bothered to put it back on, because years ago, like, this wasn't even considered a snowstorm years ago. Now it's getting to the point our winters are getting to not be what they used to be. But anyway, when I first had this sled and I tore the flap off, I didn't really have any issues. But a few different times driving on hard packed, crossing lakes, I did have the temperature light come on a few times, obviously. So when I didn't have the flap on, what I used to do in those situations, if I had to drive over hard pack for a long time, there was no way around it, and I knew the sled wasn't going to enjoy it, I used to pack my trunk full of snow. The coolers in these Crossfires, they have them in the rear and also up front. So when you pack your trunk with snow, it'll get you by for, you know, a few kilometers or so, but it's not an actual fix. So these last few years with our lower snow amounts and stuff, and a lot of times we get rain, you're driving over a lot of hard packed. It's not a nice fluffy snow. So been in a lot of situations where I've had this machine, you know, flash the temperature light and not get hot enough to hurt it, but it's letting you know that it's not happy. So PDP products, which I actually ordered these both off of Amazon, they make these nice aftermarket snow flaps that you can get with all kinds of different logos and stuff onto them, and they're quite cheap. They you can either bolt them on or rivet them on, whatever you choose to do, but they're made of a super super durable material. And I've had this one on for a few years and it's holding up great. And with the flap and your coolers in the back, you get a lot less issues with overheating, because a lot of your snow coming off your track gets directed right up towards them. But now my new mountain sled does not have these coolers in the back. So hopefully I didn't bore you guys too much with the old gear. This new gear is a little different, and obviously this sled is not really designed to be used for what I'm going to be using it for, because I don't live in the mountains. We don't have 10 feet of snow. I'm not actually going to get to fully enjoy this machine unless I put it on the truck and travel. But that being said, I want a machine that when we get a big snowstorm that I can go out and play and I don't have to wait for the groomer to bust the trails for me. And that's always been kind of my way and my attitude. And I've never had too many issues getting through trails with the Crossfire. I got a 2 1/4 powder claw on that. This one has the 3-inch powder claw from factory. But what was going on is we got a bit of snow. Obviously we can't drive in the trails because it's just fluff. You'll hit rocks and whatever. But before the snow plow went by last night, I got to do quite a few pavement runs with the old thing, or the new thing rather, both of them. And I only got about a kilometer down the road with this, maybe, we'll say a mile, about a mile down the road. And I noticed my temperature was coming up rather quickly. And with this new machine, it's nice because it has a gauge on it. It actually shows you the actual temperature of the engine, so you can see it and watch it warm up. Where this older machine, it only tells you if it's hot. And obviously in these cold days like today, minus 20, you want to start these and let them warm up. This new one, I usually let it come up to about 20, 25 degrees Celsius before I even try to move it or drive it. So anyway, I got it out for a run on the pavement and it was overheating. So not overheating, but by the time I drove the mile, got back to the yard, my temperature was up. It was showing, I think, 78 or 80, maybe 82. So it wasn't boiling the press down. It probably didn't actually do any damage to the motor, but the sled was unhappy. So even with my new flap on, because this machine doesn't have the coolers in the back, they're all the way up at the front of the tunnel, the hard pack that was on the road from everybody driving onto it, obviously, you know, this wasn't doing the job. And where this sled's a mountain sled, you can see that the track is actually back past the grab bar, where on the crossfire it's, you know, a little bit not quite there. So with this sled, to try to get the snow that comes off the track, you know, this flat may not be the best one for the application. I just bought it because, you know, it was $59 or something like that, and I figured it would do more than nothing there. So that being said, after doing the drive and coming back, I let the sled cool off, I threw some snow up in the tunnel and drove it through these plow banks here that I got in the yard, got it back down to temperature, shut it down, and I said, well, I've always heard everybody talk about scratchers, and I never ever would have dreamed in a million years that they actually do make that much difference. So after the machine cooled off, I grabbed my scratchers. This one's all full of dirt. I flipped them down and I did the same drive. I went about a mile down the road, turned around in the exact same spot, drove back to the house. By the time I got back to the house here, my sled was only running at 59 degrees Celsius. So just by having those scratchers down, and I'm sure the flap is helping some, I mean, it's got to, there's no way it can't, but you know, perhaps if this was a bit longer, or if a person geared up a, you know, something to get the flap back a little further behind the track so it got everything coming off, it might work a little better. But again, it's a mountain sled. If you're going to be using it, you really don't want a big long flap hanging off the back. That's kind of why I went with this one. But I honest to God could not believe, just by throwing those scratchers down, driving on a hard pack, you know, it was probably that deep, and I was able to drive around, you know, I put probably 25-30 miles on it last night just banging up and down the road. So now I'm considering if I shouldn't put a setup on my crossfire. But again, the crossfire doesn't have the issue so bad because it has the coolers in the back. So depending on your sled, how it's designed, shove your head up underneath the tunnel. If you don't have coolers in the back, scratchers will probably solve a lot of your issues. And the only thing I found with the scratchers, they will hook on some things, like obviously putting it in the building, you want to put them back up before you put it away. But as far as driving along the trail, driving on the road rather, not the trail, I really couldn't even tell that they were down. I didn't notice any drag in the machine or anything like that. So if you don't have a machine with scratchers and you're a long track and you're not always driving in, you know, mountainous snow areas, this might be the answer for you. So that's my two cents worth. You know, a lot of guys, obviously I'm mechanically inclined, so you know, I know that the coolant systems aren't airlocked or anything silly like that in the sleds, but if you're in doubt about that, it's recommended to hoist your nose up a bit, you know, maybe a foot, foot and a half. Don't have the machine hot, pop your cap, maybe run it for a few minutes. With the crossfire, when you run it, you can actually see the fluid starting to circulate when it's happy. So again, that stuff, I knew all that stuff was good, so it wasn't my issue. The issue was we weren't getting any snow to the front of that tunnel. And with those scratchers, it throws it on the inside of your track, which by the time it gets to the back and loops around, it catches enough of a percentage of it and it gets it up on top, and that dries it up and hits your coolers. But again, I'm sure the flap does help some. I mean, with the Crossfire, it made a huge difference. Like, there was a lot of times I had to pack the trunk of that thing to get through with other guys that had flaps on having no issues. So, lessons learned, and that snowmobile. And so I won't bore you to death anymore with today's video on overheating issues, but if you're having them, there's some insight and some things you can try to do to prevent it.